Well, hello everyone, and welcome to episode 96 of the 64 Bypass Update. Today is September the 18th, 2017. We're here at Highway 42, checking up on all the progress taking place over here. And there's a lot happening over here. First, we're going to fly over the bridge. Can't see it when you drive down the highway because your view is blocked by these trees, but they've cleared off a big section over here near the Roy Smith barn. You know, a long time ago, several months ago, I was contacted by a family member saying that barn was going to be torn down on account of the road, and they wanted me to video it so they'd have that to remember. So I made them a video, but then as the road got built, I realized, gracious, that road's pretty good ways away from the barn. I don't think they're going to mess with the barn. But now they have cleared this section all the way down to the barn, which we'll see here in just a minute. So maybe they are going to take the barn after all. I'm not quite sure why they're clearing off this area over here. Somebody in the know wants to leave us a comment on this video, that'd be good, so enlighten us as to why they're clearing this big section over here. They've built some retention ponds for erosion control. That's what they're working on here. They've already got a couple others dug out and made up. This is the one they're working on now. Here's a closer view of the old barn. It's a cinder block barn construction. I don't know how old it was or when it was built. This gives you an overview of the area and the road's on over there. A couple hundred yards away from the barn, looks to me like. Yeah, good. A nice close-up view of them digging out here. Here again, looks like they've got some really good dirt to dig here. Not much, no rocks at all, hardly. Be fun digging. Now, what's that guy's job down there in the hole holding that white pole? Something to do with letting him know if he's dug deep enough, I suppose. Okay, we will now head back toward the bridge, fly back over the stand of pines here. They're still working on finishing up the paving for each side of the bridge here, the new road section. Anxiously awaiting them getting that ready to get traffic over here on. And that section, they're working right there. The reason they keep scalping that lower and lower and lower is because that part of the roadway's got to drop on down a good ways because it has to drive underneath that bridge. So the level of the land right in through here is still too high. So they keep scalping it off and hauling it on down to a lower section. I don't know why I'm so fascinated by watching the bulldozers push the pan, but it's just interesting to watch. Filmed a little of that the other day, and got a little more of that action today here for you. Notice there's a breeze blowing toward the west, I guess that is. Smoke's a rolling. Exhaust. Wow, once again, you'll see that pan's front drive wheels. I'm not sure if I show it on this time or not. Maybe I do. His wheels slip if it's left up to him. So that's why that dozer has to be pushing there. Yeah, there, I believe he's spinning up there at the front. So it's just really tight dirt, tight soil. The red clay is tough stuff. Takes extra horsepower to break it loose from where it is. Yeah, I spotted a grass seeding crew come by a little earlier, and they're getting ready to do some seeding down here on the slope. So we'll fly on down here and check on their progress of what they're doing. All about erosion control. I spotted my friend Timmy Thomas, who is an erosion control inspector. That may be his pickup right there. You'll see him here in a little bit. It's his job to come around where they're working, doing this type of work, and make sure everything is up to snuff. Watch this guy here. He sees the drone. He says, "Bring that thing down here. Let me take a look at it. Bring it on down here." They're having a good time. So we've got the big round bales of straw, I guess that is, and they've got the wide rows of the seeded material that they roll out on these slopes to get the grass growing. So that green tractor you just saw go by, I think it has a spreader on it, a seed spreader. And so in some areas they're scattering the seed, fertilizer and seed, I think, and then they blow the straw out on top of it. In some place they're rolling out the pre-made seed material on the slopes. So sort of a combination of the two efforts. We won't fly all the way over to Pine Hill today. We'll turn around right here and take a close look at this sheep's foot compactor here. Wonder how many times back and forth he's made it through there this morning already. It was about 9:30 or so when I was there filming, I suppose. It moves right along with that thing. Now we'll fly on back up this way and check on the seeding operation again. Let's get a little closer here. Yeah, I believe that's Timmy Thomas's white pickup back there, the inspector. That's him there in the near the truck checking on things. The green sleeves. He may have to check on what kind of seed they're using and everything. I'm not sure what all is involved in his work. Getting all their stuff together. There he goes, walking back to his pickup. We'll get a little tighter shot of him here in a minute. He hears the drone and sees it. Throws me a wave here in a minute, I believe. Hey, Timmy. All right, we'll leave them to their work. I spotted something else happening over here at this retention pond. So we'll slide over here, see what's happening over this way. All kinds of different things happening at these sites. Everybody's got a job, they know what to do. I'm ignorant on all of them, just about. Okay, here's where I got just about too frisky. I decided to fly up close to this dozer, and I was almost too low. With a drone like this, you're just relying on what you see straight ahead. You don't see what's coming in from the sides. And I probably shouldn't have been quite this low. I got a real good view of this fella. But then right there, you don't see it, but I nearly got clipped by the pan coming underneath me there. I don't believe I missed him very much. So I should not have been quite that low. Okay, I think we're nearing the end of our update. Appreciate you watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Hope you have a great day.